What's up, you guys? Welcome back to the channel. If you haven't done so yet, smash that like button, subscribe with the bell notification button, consider becoming a member, and join the Patreon to help support the channel. Today, we're talking about none other than Top Gun Maverick. Okay, now, Top Gun Maverick, this was such a badass movie. I swear to God, this brought me back to the roots of Top Gun. It brought me back to 1986 when I was a kid watching Top Gun, watching Tom Cruise as Maverick flying a fucking jet at Mach 10, Mach 9. And the way they filmed this movie was so incredible, to actually put the actors in a cockpit and you can feel the G's, feel the force of the jets as they're flying through the canyons, doing their exercises. It was incredible. But let's start from the beginning, guys. I'm going to say this right now. This is a spoiler review. So, guys, if you haven't watched the movie yet, I suggest you pause this video, go watch Top Gun. Go watch Top Gun 1, then go watch Top Gun 2, which is called Top Gun Maverick. Then come back here and watch this review. So, now that I put that out there, here we go. So, right from the start, when the movie starts off, when you get the... when that music kicked in, with the bell, when that shit kicked in with the Paramount logo, I was, dude, it took me right back to 1986, dude. I was like, dude, this is fucking badass. And wouldn't you know it, it goes right into danger zone with the F-18s taking off the aircraft carrier. Fucking badass. At that point, I was 100% in the movie. I was like, dude, this is badass. And I think it's cool that you see that Tom Cruise, Maverick, for that matter, is now a test pilot doing these test missions for the Air Force. You know, he had to reach a speed of Mach 10 in that badass jet. I don't know the name of the jet. I haven't even looked it up yet. I thought it was an Aurora, but I don't think it is. I think it's something different. But nonetheless, it was badass. And to see him, you know, again, break the rules and reach Mach 10 and higher. And unfortunately, yeah, he crashes the plane, but he's just Maverick. He's badass. Doesn't fucking matter. He fucking shakes that shit off. Keeps on going. So anyway, I love that. You know, he gets pulled back in the Top Gun, you know, has the interaction with John Hamm. You know, then you find out that Miles Teller is actually Goose's son. You know, his last name is Bradshaw. Now this whole story has come full circle. And so now he has to train his son along with a whole group of other Top Gun pilots to take on a mission that is nearly impossible for any pilot to accomplish. But he has to make them believe that they can do it. Overall, I love this movie. I thought it was so badass. Yeah, there were a couple scenes that I thought were kind of like, what? But at the same time, this is Top Gun. I mean, when you compare it to Top Gun from 1986, dude, like, the sky's the limit. You could do anything you want in this movie and it still would have been badass. And but again, this is on the same realm, this is gonna sound weird, this is the same realm as Ghostbusters Afterlife, in terms of this is how you make a sequel to a cult classic badass movie like they did with Ghostbusters. This is how you do it with Top Gun. They pay respects to the original movie. You saw Val Kilmer as Iceman. You saw a lot of flashbacks to the Top Gun movie when Goose died, when they're playing Great Balls of Fire on the piano. So they did a wonderful job at capturing the essence of the first Top Gun movie. And I absolutely enjoyed this movie. I thought it was so much fun, so loud, so action-packed. It kept you on the edge of your seat. It was such a nostalgic feeling for me that what topped it all off was that I saw it with my dad. And my dad and I used to watch Top Gun all the time. Say my brother and my sister. That was a staple movie in our house growing up, was Top Gun. And to be able to see it with him was badass. So shout out to dad. That was a great experience. And I'm really glad we got to see that movie together. But anyway, one of the things I didn't like about this movie, nothing. There was nothing on this movie that I did not like. At the end, when the helicopter's gonna blow him up, I mean, like, I thought he should have just gotten blown up and died. I'm glad he didn't. He didn't die. But, and then at the end, both him and Rooster have been shot down, which somehow they both live. But hey, they can't die in this movie. Come on. Come on. So, and then they go and they steal an F-14. Now, in any other movie, I would have said that is a stupid story. Like, are you fucking kidding me? But this is Top Gun. This is Maverick. I'm like, dude, badass. Steal the F-14 and show these motherfuckers what you're made of. Because we all know that the best F-14 Tomcat pilot out there is Maverick, Tom Cruise. But yeah, no, the effects were amazing. The shots from inside the cockpit, I thought, were just so incredibly well done. And the cast as well, I thought, was perfect. I love that, you know, they got an actor in Miles Teller to play Rooster. You got John Hamm. You have Ed Harris, badass. He got a bunch of badasses to be in this movie. And not to mention his love interest, Penny, who was played by Jennifer Connelly. I thought was great casting. Perfect casting for Tom Cruise's Maverick. And then when they introduced Penny, I kept thinking, like, wait, is this the same girl from the first one? Is this Charlie? No, it's not. Unfortunately, it's not. I don't know where she's at or what she's doing now. But Jennifer Connelly kicked ass, so I enjoyed that. And at the end of the day, he still got the girl, so that was awesome. But guys, at the end, when Maverick had to go against those Generation 6 fighters, Generation 5 fighters, I can't remember at this point, he took out fucking two of them in an old-ass F-14 Tomcat. That was so badass. And then the other guy, the clone of Iceman, Hangman, he showed up and he saved them at the end, which I thought was really, really cool with the way they did that. And all the way around, dude, it was just bravo, dude. They fucking did it. They made a badass movie. Top Gun Maverick it holds up. It is right there with Top Gun in terms of being a badass movie. This movie did not let me down in one single bit. It was that damn good. So guys, let me know what you think of Top Gun Maverick in the comment section below. Make sure you smash the like button, hit subscribe with the bell notification button, become a member, and consider joining the Patreon to help support the channel. And I'll catch you guys next time. Because right now, I got a need for speed.